الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم ربنا صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Will you believe, fear Allah as he should be feared, and die not except on a state of Islam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, bestow upon us the greatest of the gift to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd, in many places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, referring to or reporting the saying of the messenger, his messenger subhanahu wa ta'ala, even teaching the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the way to tell him, say, to your people, and in the way to convey the message about an element, an aspect in the way of the belief, in the way of the creed, which is talking about the torment and the punishment as a result of the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in some of the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to his prophet to say, how can I take other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the originator of the heaven and the earth? قُلْ أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَتَّخِذُ وَلِيًّا فَاطِرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And the one who feed and not fed, I have been ordered, say that I have been ordered to be the first who submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَوَّلَ مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And I will not be from those who associate partner with Allah. قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Say, if I do disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I fear the torment of a mighty day. The torment is the truth, and it's coming with no way. And this coming with no doubt. However, the believer, not thinking about such a thing, it really make one to be deluded in his path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, if you listen, for example, the same thing that Nuh alayhi salam said. He's talking to his people, قال مَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنْ تَرَدْتُهُمْ. You want me to drive away these believers because they are poor? Who going to help me against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if I do so? Salih alayhi salam saying, I'm on clear proof of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he provided me mercy from him. وَأَتَانِي مِنْهُ رَحْمَةً. فَمَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنْ عَصَيْتُهُ. Who the one who is going to help me against Allah if I disobey him? The Messenger of Allah, as you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in a way to remind us of the great statue or status of the torment, of the punishment that awaiting the people who gain with their own hand the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in Surah Az-Zumar, after the Prophet teaching the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to say, I only worship Allah with full sincerity. And he said, قُلْ إِنَّا أَعْبَدُوا مَا شِئْتُمْ. You can worship whatever you want. I do only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, indeed, the true losers are those who lose themselves and their families in the hereafter. They will have atop them, topping them, وَلِعِيَذُ بِلَهِ clouds or layers of fire and from beneath them. Now, when you finish this ayah, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he asks us to reflect on the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, قَالَ ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَهُ. Allah, he's fearing or making fear his servant with the mentioning of this torment and the grievous penalty. So, the believer here should not in any way first think of this torment as to be, you know, the way where to go. Therefore, you just ponder and thinking about hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the hellfire, from the doom of everything and the terrifying moment in the hereafter. Because you are still here. You are still here. However, how can you make the fear of the torment of Allah an action of the heart to regulate your way of life, to regulate your steps into your journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the most important part. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you in Surah Fussilat, اعملوا ما شئتم. He's saying to the people, do whatever you want to do. Now, if you want to do anything, nobody will stop you. You want to go to any place, if you can afford it, you can go. If someone, subhanAllah, submitting and worshipping his or her own desire, they can do it. There is no limit. There is no limit, as you see it today in the world. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm watching you, I'm seeing everything you do. But who is better to come safe in the day of judgment? أَفَمَنْ يُلْقَى فِي النَّارِ خَيْرٌ أَمَّنْ يَأْتِي آمِنًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ The one who's going to be coming in the day of judgment safe, or the one who's going to be thrown in the hellfire. You choose. You choose. Now, in the reminder of such a thing, it's not about to scare yourself about the hellfire, but is a necessity in the system of the belief to integrate the remembrance, the pondering on the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a way to make a border to your life, as a way to regulate your way of life, as a way to give you firmness on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam given us a way. قال من خاف أدلج ومن أدلج بلغ المنزل. Whoever who fear, he going to hasten his pace. قال أدلج is to travel during the night. So hasten your pace to be going fast, traveling fast, you know, in full awareness. You know, someone he's watching. This is the way how you're going to get to your destination safe. Because when you travel in the night, especially talking with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the situation where there is no real safe, I mean, you might be, you know, robbed or thing. So the Prophet given us the example how someone is traveling or going home at the beginning of the night, qala adlaj. So you're going to be, you know, hasten your pace, looking around you, till, inshallah, someone get to his place, safe. This is how your travel in this life should be. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, if you do such a thing, you get to your destination safe. You get to your home. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the hadith by saying, أَلَا إِنَّ سَلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةٌ. Don't you know that the commodity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is valuable, is great, which is the sila of Allah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to offer you as a commodity, offer you as a price, is the paradise. And the paradise is great, valuable. Nobody can get it except by the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, when we're talking about that, how can we as a believer today, in the full world of distraction, in the full world drowning in entertainment and playing, how can you make such thought, such ibadah, such worship in your heart to be regulating your way? Because when you think about hellfire, alhamdulillah, I mean, someone gets scared for a moment, he read, and the problem now, the shaitan making, when you read the Quran, you read is like, this is for the disbeliever. Alhamdulillah, we are believers. This is the thought for every actually faith. They're always thinking of that doom is reserved for other people, not for them. What is about when you read is about you. Now, in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ that I have mentioned, and in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching us to raise for us an awareness so we can reflect that this doom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming with no doubt. What if you're going to be in it? Therefore, not thinking about it, it's really going to mislead you from the path. Thinking about it is going to help you regulate your action. It's going to be helpful, be watchful on your way. Because if you come at the day of judgment, starting by you're the grave, by the agony of death, who will be helping you against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. I truly fear, if I disobey, if I were to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a big punishment of one day. So imagine the best of the creation, he's saying such a thing for us to remind us that is very serious thing that we need to talk about. That is a very serious thing that you need to integrate in the planning and the projecting of your life. That's a very serious thing that you need to think about every day. Not every day to take away the hope to not act. Not every day to be passive and you retreat yourself from the life, but every day to regulate your action. Every day, because it's true. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about the angel, قَالَ وَهُمْ مِنْ خَشْيَتِهِ مُشْفِقُونَ. They're trembling from, you know, out of reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And قَالَ وَمَنْ يَقُلْ مِنْهُمْ إِنِّي إِلَاهٌ مِنْ دُونِي فَذَلِكَ نَجْزِيهِ زَهَنَّمْ. Whoever from the angel, the closest one, he will dare to utter that I am also have some attribute of the divine, he will be cast in the hellfire. Now this is the reality. So someone is saying, maybe because these are the great prophet, the best of the humankind, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them with the way of piety, so this is what they feel like if they really truly disobey Allah, but they will not disobey Allah. No, you should not think this way, because the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is real. And when we say the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is real, Allah told us even the best of His creation, if they do go astray, they're going to be taste the worst of the punishment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't create us to punish us, create us to have mercy on us. That's why you cannot extract from some of the attribute and the action of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot say Allah is the punisher. He is not subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is arhamur rahimin, the most merciful. But He punishes those who deserve to be punished. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not plot, but the plot against those who plot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't deceive, but He deceives those who deceive. يخادعون الله وهو خادعهم ومكروا ومكر الله etc. So this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قل ما يفعل الله بعذابك. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do you with your punishment, you just be grateful to Him and you'll be subhanahu to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in Him and worshiping Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want, He created you to have mercy. But this is the situation where the believer need to be mindful of, to not go astray or to transgress the gift of the free will. Because you have the free will, it does not mean that you can do whatever you want. Actually, you can do whatever you want to get to the fulfillment, to get to the happiness, to have a successful life. It's all possible for you, but don't do it in the way of people who have embraced the creed of Iblis. لعنه الله. And you thinking that you're doing great. If you do not think of the punishment by violating of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, therefore there is nothing to hold you, then nothing to stop you, there is nothing to reprimand you. And look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Surah Al-Isra, Allah said to the Prophet, if you have uttered any word that it was not revealed to you, or you have inclined to the disbeliever, trying to have them to accept Islam. It's not the objective of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be in alliance with them, but trying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to bring them to Islam. He said, they would really have loved that you say something to please them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you have done such a thing, we will have then have you to taste the double of the punishment in this life and the double of the punishment in the hereafter. إِذَنْ لَأَذَقْنَاكَ ضَعْفَ الْحَيَاةِ وَضَعْفَ الْمَمَاتِ ثُمَّ لَا تَجِدُ لَكَ عَلَيْنَا نَصِيرًا. So if, imagine this is the best of the creation, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best, the one who the best who glorified and have been thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Imam al-Muttaqeen, if he does such a thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will double for him the portion of the punishment. If he utter any word, as he said in Surah Al-Haqqa, قَالَ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ, we'll take him with our right hand and we cut off his throat. This is, you read it, it hurts, but this is to give you that perspective of what does it mean to be Allah is the full of mercy, full of kindness, but he has the most grievous penalty. If you do not try to design your path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on these two limits, then one will be totally in utter loss. Then will be someone who's like in full hope, everything is good, everything is fine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. Allah will not forgive you if you didn't have due true diligence of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you as a gift What is your free will as a gift? What is the guidance as a gift? And what is your iman? And will not blame Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you will not have any way to blame Allah. Allah gave you everything, and you are witness against yourself. Everything will witness against you in the day of judgment if you are a true believer. Therefore, to be mindful of the punishment of Allah as an action of the heart to reprimand you and to help you, to correct you, to calibrate your trajectory on the journey of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's a necessity for the believer. It's a necessity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قال تلك حدود الله فلا تعتدوا. And he said in the other ayah, تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها. Those are the limits, the boundaries of the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the laws of Allah, do not transgress it. The other one said, do not come near to it. Do not transgress it. If you are in the halal, take the halal, be grateful. Do not overdo it in a way to fall in the haram. So stay in that moderate way. And when you are, you know, facing the haram, do not come close to it. So if you design and you put your path, your trajectory in your life between this, you are in the halal, use it in the modest way, use it in the tolerable way, use it in a way to gain from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the barakah, use it and invest it in the purpose of your life. And in the other side, the haram, always far from it. This is how you're going to have the success in your life. This is mentality only will be bestowed upon you as a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you'll be mindful of the punishment of Allah. And this is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look, Salih alayhi salam, as I have said, قال, who can help me against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No one. No one. Now, how can we develop such a thing? Because subhanAllah, someone will be always distracted by all what we have around us. Of course, reading the Quran is a necessity for you to reflect. If you read the Quran as it addressed to you, not Allah talking about other people, Allah talking about you. If you are, there is a fire, you might be in it. And the Prophet ﷺ, he taught us every time he comes from ayah of adab, when he goes through an ayah of punishment, he seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from such a thing. Nuh alayhi salam, to see, you know, in a way how the prophets, they know, because we are not able to have such thought to be part of our aspect of life, to have an impact of our choices, if we do not know Allah, if we do not pay due diligence to the reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salam given us the example. When Nuh alayhi salam asked and requested from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spare his child, his son, because he thought that he's from his family, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, take him with you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, take the believers. But Nuh is a father. He's a father. He loves his child. And he asked him to embark with him. He said, no, I will not. I'm going to be find the refuge in a summit of a mountain. But la asima, there is no refuge from the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was from those who drowned. Now Nuh talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way he talked to Nuh, and he said, ya Nuh, this is not from your family. What you have done is not a righteous deed. Ya Nuh, do not ask me about things that you do not have knowledge. And I warn you, Nuh, to not be among the ignorant ones. Can you imagine, put this talk, the way Allah reproaching Nuh alayhi salam, in a balance, and in the other side, on the scale, put 950 years of action, of continuous action and striving on Nuh in da'wah. 950 years of action, of real striving, of one of the greatest prophet of Allah and messenger of Allah, Nuh alayhi salam, is about to flow away, is about to be perished, Why? Because of the reproach and admonition to Allah, to Nuh alayhi salam. And if you know this, if you put this in the balance, then you can evaluate ourselves, you can evaluate your mizan, your balance in the scale of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look, Nuh, he was begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, ya Allah, if you do not forgive me, if you do not have rahmah on me, he forget about his son, he forget about anything else. What Allah if does not forgive you? Don't we have hearts today? Do You think if Allah will not forgive you, where are we going to be? That's the feel of the punishment. That's the biggest of the punishment. If Allah refused to forgive you. Allah giving you all the tayyibat. He said, kulu from the tayyibat, wa la tatghaw fihi. And do not transgress. Then if you do transgress, then my wrath will descend on you. And whoever on whom Allah's wrath descend, he perish. وَمَنْ قَالَ وَمَنْ يَحْلِلْ عَلَيْهِ غَضِبِي فَقَدْ هَوَى. Let's have a parable in our mind to help us calibrate, to help us evaluate our situation. The Sirat, in the Day of Judgment, all of us will go to cross on top of the Sirat. And by the way, not everybody is going to cross on the Sirat. Those who are candidate to get to Paradise. Because the people, wal-iyadu billah, who will not make it to the Sirat, they already fall from the beginning. When they say, we are looking for a God, he said, go find it, the angel, go find it. All of them, subhanAllah, in this dense cloud, they fall in this darkness, they fall, all of them in hellfire, and hellfire, its flame is black. So if you have you are candidate to get to paradise, you're going to cross the Sirat. And Sahih Muslim, how the Sirat? Can you describe the Sirat? The Sirat, as he's been, came in the description of the Prophet ﷺ, قال أَدَقُّ مِنَ الشَّعْرَةِ وَأَحَدُّ مِنَ السَّيْفِ. It's like as thin as a hair and as sharp as the blade. Is anyone, even if it was this path, this bridge on top of the water and you are a good swimmer, you'll not be able even to cross it. Therefore, you only the help of Allah. What you need is the help of Allah. You do not have any power, you do not have any strength, you don't have anything. No one of us will be able to cross the Sirat, except by the will of Allah. The same thing, you will not be able to journey into your life without the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same, because the Sirat reflects exactly our life. If you will not be able to make design your path by making this hand of the punishment to be fearing as a way of your heart to regulate and correct your action, therefore, you'll not be able even maybe to be candidate to cross the Sirat. And what you need here, you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, veneration into your heart. Because you will not be able to fear Allah's punishment if you do not fear Allah. If you do not know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I have said, ask ourselves, do we still have heart? If you think that Allah might be not, subhanAllah, willing to forgive you, what are you going to do? That's the true fear. It's a healthy fear. It's a beautiful fear. Why? Because it's going to have you to have like strength and enhance your drive toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala path. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was dying after he's been stabbed, to see the veneration, to see the example, to see the example, Umar al-Faruq, shaheed, martyr, his son Abdullah has to be on his thigh, you know, feeling for his father, grieving. What Umar said, his father, he said, may your mother mourn you, put my head on the ground. Why? He want to show the humility to Allah. He want to show his modesty to Allah. Because he needs to be forgiven. And he was, people, Umar, Abdullah was listening. And what Umar was saying at that moment, in the last moment of his life. وَيْحَكَ عُمَرْ إِنْ لَمْ يَغْفِرْ لَكِ اللَّهِ. Woe to you, Ya Umar, if Allah will not forgive you. Umar. You see how healthy is the fear. From a punishment that is coming with no doubt. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I make this to have you to have that healthy part in your heart. To be a virtue that conduct you, that help you, that correct you. Not to cast you in hellfire. But do not come from a gate that you will have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have you be cast in hellfire. Because we did it to ourselves. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. Dear brother, respected sister, if you just reflect on what we have shared with you, we will be like the messenger of Allah, like Salih alayhi salam. You are on a clear proof of Allah. You are on the true guidance. Anything that calls you to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's really worth it. Anything that calls you to disobey Allah is calling you to the way of confusion, to the way of doubt. When you are on the path and you're standing on certainty, so how can you move to doubt and confusion and leave the place of certainty? Then you're going to say to anything that calls you, is more profit in a business, bet is haram, a good career, bet you're going to lose your soul in it. Or anything, subhanAllah, that call you and is going to strip away the true and the good part of you, you're going to say no. Allah gave me already the rahmah. And there is no one who can help me against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if I disobey Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made to be the greatest success is when you are moved away from hellfire. كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة. Everyone is going to taste death, so this is your destination. This is the last dwelling that you will have in this life. Everyone is going to have a home called grave. Everyone in this life. And then you're going to be called for account for what you have done. If you're going to be pushed, if you're going to be saved, if you're going to be like pushed hardly from hellfire, that is the greatest of success. And this is what brings you to reflect, to think, as Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, to finish this khutbah and to be go home with this reflection of one of the grandchildren, grandchildren of Umar ibn al-Khattab, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, from this our great Salaf. He was around his wife and his people and some of his servants, and suddenly he started to cry. I mean, in a deep crying, deep tears. To the point that everyone around him, his wife and everyone, was crying. And then, when he stopped, she asked him, he said, what made you cry, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, Prince of the Believer? He said, an ayah in the Book of Allah. She said, an ayah, a verse in the Book of Allah did this for you? He said, yes. She told him, what ayah? Just to remind ourselves. He said the ayah in Surah Ash-Shura, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we have revealed to you Quran, to convey it and to warn the people, the mother of the city, which is Mecca, and whatever around it, which is the world. وَلِتُنْذِرَ يَوْمَ الْجَمْعِ, and to the warn the day of the gathering. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ, a group in paradise and a group in hellfire. He said, when this ayah crossed my mind, I stopped, I imagined myself standing in the land of resurrection, in this day of the gathering, and I'm waiting to be called, and you don't know where you're going to go, and all of you, you're going to stand there. That's why Umar was crying. And that's what the meaning to make out of this a virtue, to make out of it an action of your heart, to be part of your daily life, and you'll see how it changed your life. Not to relate or the punishment of hellfire and the doom of hellfire and how severe is this fire, no. But to just to use it today because you need it. You need it for your path. You need it for your success. You needed to contemplate better and ponder in the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah shield us from hellfire. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boost our iman. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon us the virtues who help us to correct our trajectory and calibrate our way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna tiba'ah wa arina al-batila batilan wa waffiqna lijtinabah. برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقيم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.